Hello friends, Srinivas here. Welcome to our channel. And I'm going to cover one of the interesting topic here today in Oracle Fusion. So that is sandbox. Okay. So there is a functionality called sandbox, which we can enable in Oracle Fusion and do certain kind of customizations like for page and other customizations. Okay. And later you can deploy these changes to the environment. Okay, so we'll see like how we can enable sandbox, and we'll take one business case and how we can use this sandbox functionality effectively for our business requirement. Okay. So what is sandbox? Sandbox means it's a customized environment you can enable in Oracle standard environment, and you just want to enable it and create certain R&D, create certain changes into the forms and other details and pages, and later if after testing, after thorough testing into these changes, if you think that these are fulfilling your customer requirement, you can deploy this by publishing this sandbox to Oracle environment or Fusion environment. Okay. So once we publish the sandbox, then whatever changes we made into the configurations, pages, and any other changes, so that will be effective into the real environment. Okay. So let us see. So let me discuss the business scenario, how we can use this sandbox and what changes we are going to do. So let me explain the business scenario. Okay. So now I'll navigate to fixed asset model. Okay. And we have to do certain changes as per the business requirement. I'll explain what is the requirement and why we need sandbox, and to change that configuration or form so that it can be useful for our business. So I'm going to the fixed asset model. Okay. Fixed asset. Okay. So here you can see lot of assets are there. So let me go to tax panel and retire assets. So our requirement is related to retirement accounting, asset retirement accounting. So let me find out one asset number. So select the first one in the list and click on the retired cost. Okay. And here, suppose we are going to retire one assets, and once you retire one asset, it will generate certain kind of accounting in the future model. So as per business requirement, business telling that there is a field cut retirement region. Okay. So business is telling, business requirement is that accounting should be generated, or accounting lines should be generated as per the retirement regions. So there are two retirement regions are there. You can create more from the retirement lookup. There can be multiple retirement regions. Okay. Here it is showing two, and for each of the retirement region, the accounting will be different. Okay. So retirement region is one of the attributes, one of the source which will be used in SLA. And once the user will enter the retirement region, the accounting will be happen accordingly. So that is our business requirement. Okay. Suppose if the retirement region is extraordinary, the account will be different. If it is retirement region will be sale, then again it will create a different accounting. So in this way, you have to use this retirement region attributes and create some accounting rules so that the retirement accounting will be generated as per the business requirement. So this is our primary requirement. But here, when the user will create the retirement details, will provide all the information here. But the retirement regime, the form or the field is not mandatory here. User can skip this information, okay? Because it is not mandatory field. But our SLA is dependent on these attributes, and that is retirement regime. So, to work the SLA accounting generation effectively, so we must have to enter this retirement region field. But as it is not mandatory, it can be possible that user may skip this field as it is not mandatory, and user can save these informations without entering the retirement region detail. So to avoid this problem, what we can do, we can make this field as mandatory field for user. So user must have to provide this retirement region informations while executing one asset retirement. So by default, this field is not mandatory, but we have to go to one sandbox environment. We have to make this field mandatory so that user must have to enter this retirement region field before completing the retirement. So you can see here the cost retired, this is mandatory. You must have to put this information, cost information. But retirement region, as it is optional field, user can skip, and the accounting cannot happen as per the expectation because we are not filling this field. So now our requirement is to go to create one sandbox and make this field mandatory, okay? And again, we have to publish this changes to the real environment so that user can use this retirement region field as a mandatory option. So this is the complete business requirement. Now let us go to our main springboard or navigation. So now we'll see how we can enable the sandbox. Okay. So now go to tool. Sorry, configuration. If you go to navigator, you will see your configuration. Okay. Just click on sandbox, okay? Click on sandbox. Create one sandbox. The sandbox name is, you can give like asset retirement. Okay. Sandbox name is asset retirement. So you can see for the sandbox, there are a lot of tools are there. Application composer, manage, service mapping, appearance, structure. So what tools you need to use for your requirements, that you need to enable. Okay. So for the time being, I can enable everything, but this is not required to enable for all. But as we are working on a sandbox environment, we can experience or we can do R&D a lot of things here. So all these tools have different purpose, and we can use all these tools as per the business requirement. For my specific requirement, I have to use the page composer. So that is one of the tool, because I have to make that field mandatory in the asset retirement page. Okay. So that's why I have to enable this tool. So in addition to this, I have enabled all the tools. That is not mandatory. You can enable or disable as per your requirement in the specific sandbox environment. Okay. So let me create and enter. So if you create and simultaneously enter into the sandbox. So now the sandbox is, you can see here, the sandbox mode is activated here. The sandbox name is Asset Retirement, and this is the sandbox mode. So this is not the normal mode. So whatever changes you will make here, it will not be applicable to our real environment. Okay. To make it applicable to the real environment, you have to publish whatever changes you have made into the sandbox. Okay, so that is mandatory. So before publishing, we have to do the thorough testing whether whatever changes we made, it is working properly or not, and it is satisfying our business need. So that you need to confirm and ensure. So before publishing the sandbox, because it is specific to certain requirement, and if you publish it, then it will be applicable for all users and all the complete environment will be affected. So that is, we need to very, very careful before publishing this sandbox. Okay. So we need to 100% ensure that whatever changes we have made, it will not affect negatively to any other functionality. Okay. So now we have enabled the sandbox. Now go to again to the assets module, navigate to Fetch Asset, Asset. So go to Tax Panel and click on Retired Asset. Find out one asset number. Just we wanted to navigate to that field and just select the asset number, one of the asset number, and click on the retire cost. So this is the asset retirement page. Okay. So our task is to enable this retirement region option so that whenever user will enter the asset retirement detail, so this field will be mandatory and it needs to enter one of the value from the LOB as per the requirement. So the retirement region, whether we are selling the assets or any other regions, any other purpose we are retiring this asset. It may be damage, sale, extraordinary, or you are moving to other location, from one location to other location. So we can create lot of regions in the assets retirement lookup types, and it will be available here. Okay. And this attributes, this retirement region attributes, you can use in SLA accounting rules and create accounting rules so that retirement account will be generated as per this region. So now go to asset retirement tool. So you can see whatever tools we have enabled there in the sandbox level, so they are visible here. Just go to page composer. Okay. So this is page composer. Just select, come to this field, retirement region. Go to structure. So click on the structure here. So you can see one grid is visible on that particular section. Okay. So you can see here one pop-up is showing here, confirm shared component edit. Are you sure you want to edit this shared component? So you are opening a shared components for editing. Okay, just click on edit. So you are going to edit that particular field, retirement regions. So select, click on select. Okay, so now another options, another pop-up is coming here, and you can see here two links, hyperlinks here, and just click on edit components. Okay, so component properties, retirement region. So that particular field we need to make it mandatory. So you can see here in this particular screen, you can see here in the particular screen, this is required button is disabled here, just enable it. Okay. You can give here some certain description, like why you are going to enable this field. And click on apply and click on OK. So now you can see star mark is visible here for the retirement region. So when user will enter any retirement informations, so he cannot skip this field because it is now enabled as mandatory field. Okay. So now it is enabled as mandatory field. You can see the message here. You must mark at least one selection. So now you can close this. So now this field is mandatory, and as our SLA rules or retirement accounting is dependent on this retirement region, user will put the information here for retirement regions, and accordingly SLA accounting will be generated. So in this is one particular business case we have demonstrated here. So there are a lot of things you can leverage here from sandbox functionality, and you have to analyze the requirement, and accordingly you can enable the sandbox and you can make the required changes and publish into the real environment. Okay. So now just cancel this. And now we have done the changes under the sandbox mode. So these changes will not be applicable to our real environment. What you can do, so that changes we made, it will be effective only if we publish this, and it will be applicable to all the users. So I am not publishing it, just for demo purpose I am showing you how it will be effective. So that is a small business case I have shown you with respect to sandbox. And for any module, any functionality, either page or configuration, you can change under a sandbox mode, and you can publish it later after the thorough testing, and leverage the sandbox functionality. So that's all for today, guys. And if you like this video, you can share, comment, and click on like button and subscribe to our channel. And thank you for watching this video.